Hi, I'm John Noser. I'm here with Board Game Geek TV. I'm at Spiel 2014. I'm here with Marco of Winter Lair Games, and we're taking a look at Everzone. So give me an overview of what this game's about.
Yeah. Okay. This is a strategic card game set in a sci-fi background. So it's been inspired from many movies, games about sci-fi. Okay. So imagine that inside the box there are 330 cards, okay, already divided into six pre-builded decks, because it's a sort of deck building, okay. Each deck must be of only one race among humans, Zlars and Uthrons. More said, humans, aliens and robots, okay. And one deck could be of 50 cards, and inside your deck can be units and supports, only two kind of cards, okay.
That okay.
Marshal or deployed as you wish, and activated on different battlefields. Okay, so before the game, players choose to create a sort of battle deck. Okay, with location among Earth, Sea, and Space. Okay, each location provides a different number of battle turns. Okay, and each turn the location provides a different amount of resources that you will need to activate your cards. Okay, so the units must be marshaled, okay, before the battle, so marshaled cover, while the supports must be played directly from the hand, like a surprise, okay? Then, each turn, you can activate any number of units with the limit imposed by the resources each turn, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. So, here you can find three parameters: attack, defense, and range. Range is like initiative. Why? Because both players activate units at the same time. Okay. So first of all, you have to look to the range. So the highest range attacks first. Okay. Then you will look at the attack. In this case, he attacks first because it's 3 versus 1. 3-2 in defense. So this card is destroyed. And the opponent, so I take 1 damage. So the only way to suffer damage, to cause damage, is the rest of the attack. Okay.
I got it.
Yeah, it's very simple. But this game has a mechanics a little bit different from other games of this kind. First of all, this is not a game about unit versus unit, but it's a game about armies, army versus army. Okay. So if you've got 2 or more units active on your battlefield, you have to sum their parameters, okay? And then, if you destroy the opposing army, you destroy each active card, okay? Then you can have, naturally, many more marshaled cards, okay? So, cover card that you can activate the next round. Another important mechanic is that this game tries to avoid or even reduce the luck in the card games.
Okay.
You say, I had a good deck, but the problem is that I draw bad cards, no? Typical.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, not, because you start with 10 cards in hand,
okay?
Then you can discover, for instance, the battlefield, okay? I say, oh no, I don't like my hand, I can refresh my hand, so discard 10 and draw 9. I don't like, I can draw discard 9 and draw 8,
okay,
until I have only one card. When your deck ends, you can shuffle again the discarded cards. Then, after the battle, so after the latest turn, you can discard any number of cards from your hand and draw in again up to 10. So you have always 10 cards in hand for each battle.
A lot of flexibility in kind of finding cards that you want from your deck.
Exactly, because in this game it's not important the luck of drawing, it's important your strategy. So in general, it works.
Okay, that sounds nice. How many players? Is this just a two-player game, or
can you? 6 players. You can play 1 versus 1, 2 versus 2, 3 versus 3, or there is also a rule for 3 players with the tokens that are inside of the box.
Okay, and how long does it normally take?
30 minutes, 1 hour. It depends on how many life points you want, common points, he said, you want to use, or maybe it depends also on the run of the game, etc.
So how does it end? Is it just to a certain amount of points, or a certain amount of rounds, or when does the game end?
The game ends when a player reduces the opponent's life common points to zero.
Okay, so you actually are eliminating someone.
Or when the battle deck ends, the player with most life points wins.
Okay, that seems simple enough.
It's very simple, but very strategic, because you can do many strategies. One last thing, there is one leader per game, per player. I mean, you can have one leader, okay, per game, mm-hmm. each player, naturally. And the leader is a sort of joker, that means he can be activated on any occasion, and when a battle ends, it's not discarded like the other cards, but it returns to your hand that can be marshaled and potentially activated on any in any battle.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks for the overview.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you.